Here we go. So we have a key card. We never actually found the exit yet, but I'm assuming it's like over here. I never clicked on most of the screen yet.
Something to click on.
Door?
We'll probably keep moving to back to the where the...
No, this way.
Yes.
Oh, it's so weird. There we go.
Lock.
All right. Let's just swipe this card. Junpei, look. It's unlocked.
Yeah. Now we can go back to the library.
Hurry up, Junpei. We don't have time. Let's go.
We could go faster if everyone didn't have to chime in one by one. All right. Let's go. We did it. Let's go, Andrew.
Like, I get it. The visual novels are supposed to be, like, long, but fuck you. Like, there's a difference. At least, like, the length has purpose. This is just, like, we don't want you to leave yet. Please don't leave.
Hey. Stopped. The audience can see the achievements now because you changed the recording settings.
Oops. I'm sorry.
It would seem so, but we are yet to be out of danger. You're right. Let's hurry.
This exit needs the Uranus card, too. Hey, Junpei.
Yeah, I know. All right, it's open. Let's go. Okay, Neptune P, let's see if you work. Yes, I think it unlocked. It says incinerator. So this is the incinerator.
Maybe it's a different
first
one.
First time I've seen it from this side, but
plot
yeah,
twist.
I think so.
Then there ought to be a lever near the door. Yeah, right here. Pull that and the door should open. Got it.
Question. Why does a boat need an incinerator?
Let's go.
Like, I get, you know, a small one for trash, but, like, this is a huge fucking incinerator.
I don't have an answer.
Oh, because it was being used as a medical ship, so this is how you get rid of the dead bodies. When you have multiple dead bodies piling up, you throw them all into the incinerator.
It's huge, though.
Disease is a bad thing.
It's so big that it would be like an incinerator for the entire population of the ship.
I mean,
this is like a setup to Ghost Ship 2. Oh no! Everyone was having a happy party, and someone turned on the incinerator. Everyone dies except that one little girl again, because she was in a fireproof suit, I guess, instead of just being short.
Jesus!
Have you seen Ghost Ship?
No.
Oh. Everyone's having a party on top of some old-timey ship, and then a wire goes straight across the top, like horizontally, and just cuts everyone in half. But there's a little girl, so she lives, because she's shorter than the wire that went across and cut everyone in half.
Okay.
It's like, it's a haunted ship, and it goes in circles, and I don't remember the rest of the story, really. But it was just...
Like the little girl being too short for all of the ghost ship traps?
I think she slowly starved to death on the ship and, like, possessed it or something. I don't really remember.
What?
I feel like...
Wait, what? She took over the...
I feel like nobody really ever remembers what happens in that movie beyond specifically the scene where everyone dies at the very beginning. That's the most memorable part of the movie.
I can't imagine that somebody dying can then take precedence over another haunted ship. Like, someone dies on the ship and it's like, it's mine now! And it's like, but I was doing it!
Well,
now, get out!
I didn't say it was haunted before.
The ship just sucked?
I think it was just an accident that everyone died in, and that was it. That was just it. That was the
But
setup.
Then you also said the ship goes in circles and shit.
No, that's after she haunts. She's haunting it. The whole part where everyone dies and then she and then
oh,
she's
that's
alone,
like a, the prequel
the,
kind
yeah,
of thing.
That's the cold open. Then the actual cast shows up on the ghost ship and they're like probably like scavenging or something.
The fucking awful movie. God.
Look forward to our commentary on Ghost Ship next week.
Ghost Ship.
What the hell is going on? What's wrong? Are you okay?
Jumpy, you came to get me.
Of course I did. I made a promise.
I'm so glad you're here. So glad.
Hey, what happened to you?
I'm fine. I just fainted. I wasn't feeling very good.
Are we going to find out the reason why June hasn't seen Junpei since they were like 9 years younger is because she's been dead the entire time?
Yes.
And then she's like, she's somehow back because she's like, I don't know, inhabiting a mannequin or something. But like, that's the reason why they lost touch is because she's just been dead. Which I feel like would come up at some point. Like, oh, by the way, your friend from school has been missing for a decade.
It's also weird that he didn't hear any piece of paper about her being dead.
I don't know.
Like, someone had to register that she died.
Maybe it's all repressed nonsense, because we're dealing with a story that uses amnesia as a plot point, which means whatever. It's like, we could be screwed.
Let's just get this shit over with.
A lot better now, though.
Are you sure?
God damn it.
Yes. I just need to rest a little longer. You shouldn't worry about me.
Could you... Okay.
What?
You know, look, I get it. It's like, this is a DS game, and you're upscaling, you know, like, things like that. Could you at least not fucking make the background look like literal shit? Like, it's squared and discolored and pixelated, and it's clearly like you took the render and just zoomed into the max size you could, and then put a really nice HD picture over it. Like, why did you do this?
Yeah.
That just looks awful.
It's not great, but I'm it's just way too late in the game to be phased by that
like
at this point.
One of like a million missteps that this game has done in its entire existence.
Let's just simmer down a little bit and just try to proceed. This is not the time to go back to like talking about the backgrounds.
Santa.
Hey, where is it? Where's the gun? You hide it somewhere?
I don't have it. I got sucker punched and they took the gun.
What? Who took it?
What? Isn't that obvious?
I took the gun.
Ace.
Just what the hell do you think you're doing, Ace? Or maybe I ought to say Gintaro Hongo, CEO of Cradle Pharmaceuticals. You have me at a disadvantage. And I don't like that. You know me, but I don't know you.
You don't?
Wait, what?
What, you don't? Like, holy shit.
Isn't that the guy that made you angrier than anyone ever?
I guess the scars don't give it away?
I guess he just forgot who he... Yeah, where did the scars... I guess the scars must have happened just on the job at some point, because they weren't covered, were they?
No.
Do you have any idea how much I've suffered? Can you even begin to understand my pain?
What?
Frankly, we've had more storytelling about you than almost any other character so far, and I've had no indication of why you would have pain.
Yeah, what the fuck is your pain? The pain that you didn't get to watch, like, four children burn to death? You only got to watch one? Like, I don't
Man,
know.
All this power and money really sucks.
Yeah! All this money and all I can afford is a fucking turtleneck.
Look at how much I'm suffering.
I mean, he can't afford his pinstripe suit anymore, so it must be pain.
What a tragedy. Weirdly, his clothes look like some sort of strange tribute to Santa who escaped with similar-looking clothes at the time.
The pain of prosopagnosia, right?
Another irritating insect. And how do you know that,
Good question.
No matter. If you don't want to answer, it makes no difference to me. This is a waste of time, anyway. It's time for me to go.
Is it? Revolvers can only carry 6 bullets in
First
them.
First is one.
So he can only shoot 6 of us.
Yeah. Well, also... Santa fired one of the shots.
He can only shoot 5 of us, which makes it even easier. That means that, like, one of us is gonna get that gun from him, and we're all gonna burn in the incinerator.
How did they get here?
How did it take this long? That's what I'm surprised about.
I lose track of this stuff a lot, because we can't walk around in a 3-dimensional space to, like,
they
actually
take in
the environment.
They got here from the first door, remember? So I guess when they went through that first door, there was a...
So in the other ending where we got to the incinerator, they had to do all the puzzles, I guess? And
yeah.
And then we just walked... It's weird how one of the endings, in one of the doors, you just walk here. In the other door, you do 2 puzzle rooms, apparently. But we keep getting here at such similar timing, it's as if no time was spent in that gargantuan pair of puzzle rooms. Like, in one of them, we had to search an entire library, and the other one, we had to solve several previous puzzles. And then we had time for a giant flashback, but it feels like they left... But also, even before that, they ran off before we even encountered Snake. We've had, like, what might be, like, 4 hours of revelations back-to-back.
Yep.
And puzzle-solving. And they're acting like it's been 2 minutes. Like, the timing is really strange feeling. Which is what happened last time, too. Like, they somehow seemed to get through all the puzzles in, like, 2 minutes, but what?
8. And with this, 9.
The 9th man, Kubota's bracelet.
I believe I've won this game. I've had quite a time playing with you.
I must thank Zero, I suppose.
Wait, what? Ace doesn't know who Zero is. What the hell are you planning, Santa?
At any rate, this game ends now. I will escape, and the rest of you will have a slightly less pleasant ending. I suggest you enjoy your final moments. Goodbye.
Wait!
What? Why isn't it opening?
Could it be that the numbers are lying?
One more time.
Jesus.
Just kill her if you're going to do that. God.
Now open.
I'm just confused why he keeps going back down.
Yeah, why did he go back down the stairs?
Yeah, he keeps going, like, he apparently went up the stairs, then back down, then back up, and, like, just fucking stand up there.
What a fucking asshole.
No! What is this? Why? The digital route should be 9! It has to be 9! Then why? Why isn't it opening? Now!
Yay.
No.
Oh, that was close. Too close. Thank you, Seven.
Seven for MVP. Everybody in the comments, vote for MVP. Options 1 through 9 are 7777777777. Those are all the options. Vote for 7 for president.
Dial on your smartphone.
Dial down the 7.
Don't mention it. Just one punch ain't enough for this piece of shit.
Jesus.
What he did 9 years ago, I ought to rip him to pieces.
Or just punch him 9 times.
Can't talk, they ain't much good. Once he's locked up in a cell, we're gonna have a little chat.
9 years ago? Then you must be...
Yeah, you finally figured it out, dumbass.
Fuck.
Ace, you killed Kubota, Nijisaki, and Musashido, didn't you?
Wait, Nijisaki?
Oh, right. You don't know yet. All right, we'll just go through them in order then. Let's start off with Kubota.
Well, he didn't even mention Snake was with them.
Who didn't mention Snake Ace. Was with who?
Ace didn't say a single thing about, like, wait, Snake's alive? When Snake walked in with all of us.
Yeah, he weirdly,
he didn't, like, he wasn't shocked by that fact.
He was probably a little distracted with the whole hostage situation, but yeah, he didn't react to the fact that the person he thinks he's killed is, right. Well, he didn't react because he doesn't know it's Snake. Because he has face blindness.
Oh, right, different clothes.
Yeah.
Oh.
He still thinks he killed Snake. He doesn't know who the new guy is, but I mean,
he's not concerned. There's some dude in a fucking robe that just showed up.
They've already found at least one other strange person just, that was dead already, but still, like, yeah, they keep finding people somehow. For all he knows, like, I don't know, somebody changed clothes. I don't have time for that right now. Hostage situation. Like, he's a little distracted.
Who could be left?
Ah. Kubota's back. He's in a robe. So I remember that. It's Kubota's bathrobe.
Jesus. That's a little...
You talked to Kubota and managed to convince him to go into door 5 alone. You killed him without making it look like you killed him. The way I figure it, you had 4 motives. 1. In the Nonary game, the number 9 is dangerous. Whoever had the 9 bracelet could join whatever team they wanted. Adding 9 to any number doesn't change the digital route.
Which is dangerous because?
Because that means that he could screw over an entire group by just going with them instead.
He doesn't, no group needs him ever, except for the total number, and that's it.
But I'm saying he could be attached,
like,
to a
he's
group.
He's exclusively helpful in the Nonary games.
Except when the last door comes up.
Perhaps. But that's true for everybody. Everybody could be going through the door at cost of somebody else.
Yeah, but I'm saying that it's dangerous because a group that normally wouldn't be able to go because they can only make up, like, 2? Say 2 people can only make up 9. He can just walk in and be like, I'm going to go with that group. It's like, but...
But there's still tons of configurations of 3 people that can go through.
Yeah, but what if those 3 people don't want to do that? What if there's like pairings, like that people pair off with each other? I don't know. I'm just saying, like, 9 can be... You can use 9 as, like, an all... Like, an all... Like,
we'll
a god
see,
mode
We'll
tool.
See if it explains it, but I see no reason why 9 is magically dangerous as opposed to incredibly helpful.
Which means that number 9 could do whatever they wanted. You wanted to remove that threat as soon as possible.
Wait, what?
Please tell me why it's a threat, please.
2.
No, Junpei, when you're over-explaining, you gotta explain your reasoning.
You wanted the number 9 bracelet for yourself, so that you could make use of its power. In fact, you did use it in the murder of Niji Saki. 3. Even if his number hadn't been 9, Kubota was a problem. He knew your past. He knew what had happened 9 years before. You needed to silence him before he told anyone. 4.
Except half the people here knew.
Yeah.
It sure is convenient you didn't recognize 7, who looks basically the same minus scars.
But last, and perhaps the most disturbing, you used Kubota as a test. You wanted to know how serious this nonary game was. Was it truly life or death, or simply a harmless prank?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I think the kids didn't have bombs. I think they just told them they had bombs. But I think...
Did they even tell them they had bombs?
Well, that's... Otherwise, you wouldn't have the bracelet and the dead. There'd be no reason why you would have a dead at all. Because in the dead... Like, the bracelet... The bracelet makes no sense, because what? It just has a skull flashing, and you're like, ugh, where's the fucking box to make it shut up? Like, so I think they told them that, but they obviously weren't going to put bombs in children, because it's a little extreme. Incinerator's not, but a bomb's too much.
Because somehow the older children lived, apparently. Although we didn't get to hear the rest of the story about how they got off the boat.
Yeah.
Just kind of stopped.
You convinced him to break the rules so you could see what would happen. That was why you killed Kubota. But he was only the first. Next was Niji Saki. While everyone was off looking for the missing parts for the Reds, you ran into Niji Saki near the big hospital room. However, because of your prosopagnosia, you didn't realize he was Niji Saki. Chiefly because, when you met him, he was dressed like Snake. That was why you thought Niji Saki was Snake.
No, that's not... That was Niji Saki? Why? How did...
Twist!
So I guess Niji Saki never spoke, so you could recognize his voice.
He had just,
being
they said he had
different.
Just woken up.
But he never said anything, even while he's being, like, murdered?
He did, but once he like was pushed into the room, I think he was probably like, ah, and then...
Because, like, these two people probably had really different voices, and that just kind of... I feel like
well, I think Ace probably just pushed
wise.
Him... I think Ace just pushed him in and, like, walked away.
That's just confusing.
Because, I mean, what does it matter at that point? Because Ace...
Zero, also, I'm just talking about how Zero's plan relies on so many really convenient things to happen, involving, like, people with face... Like, well, his face blindness. Oh, clothes, only clothes. Surely couldn't pick them out based on voices. Sure, it's a good thing they never said anything.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. And then also, like, oh, sure is convenient this really specific configuration of people didn't remember each other, and it sure is convenient that Ace didn't remember anyone else.
Look, Keith, it's all fucking...
Because there's other people he could have recognized.
The whole game's just full of conveniences, man. Like, the whole... Everything about this is just, oh, how fortunate.
Like,
how fortunate.
Literally, the plan is, like... Like, now that we know other people... Like, at the time, it was like, oh, yeah, he tried to kill Snake because he was from the Nonary Games. But now we know, like, half the people here were there.
Everyone
like,
but
Snake
well, everyone
there,
but me
and
Junpei Lotus.
Junpei was there, and Seven was there.
Junpei wasn't there.
I mean, sorry, June. I mean, the names are all identical.
Junpei and
so
Lotus.
So many names are almost identical.
Junpei and Lotus
me.
Are the only two people who are never a part of the Nonary Games.
Yeah. So, like, he's like, I gotta get rid of 9, and I got rid of the other people. Like, he has no apparent plan. Like, he makes no move to get rid of Santa or June or 7 at any point. And we just found out he apparently never recognized 7, even though he changes the least out of anybody because he was already an adult.
Yeah.
So you don't even have, like, puberty to blame it on. Although 7 looks the fucking same, too. And also June looks the same.
Wait, but remember, he can't recognize their faces.
Right.
So he can't recognize 7's face.
Yeah.
And clothes don't make a difference with 7, because the last time we saw him, he was wearing, like, a police outfit or, like,
wow.
A police suit. The propaganda is, like, literally a deus ex machina on why this all can work.
You're right.
It's
because,
like,
yeah.
Some dude just...
Every time I think of explanations, I forget about it again because of how contrived it is.
Yeah, it's just like, so convenient that this one guy literally can't see any humans on the ship. He just sees clothes walking around. Like, that's the most convenient escape for, like, why this whole thing doesn't go to shit. I don't know why... And then another thing, you go, like, okay, well, it's not that contrived. Yeah, because Snake is also blind. And he can't... so, Snake can't see that it's 7, who saved him when he was a kid, So, like, and Clover wasn't
there. So, in order
to
deal with the fact that an entire ship is filled with people that all know each other already and would probably want to kill each other in some configurations, one person's blind, one person has face blindness, another person has amnesia, and another person might be back from the dead? Like, what the fuck,
yeah, one person's like a spoopy ghost who doesn't remember anybody but Junpei?
That might be over the, like... That's I think that's beyond the high water mark for character contrivances to explain a story being able to happen.
Also, by the way,
that's overkill.
For those,
man.
Like, I can feel it. They're like fingers tingling with frustration. If you want to like argue this,
watchers are strong.
Yeah, if you just want to argue that this is anime, it's not anime. This is like this is bottom barrel like bullshit anime that no one would ever want to watch. It's
Andrew
garbage.
Consumes anime obsessively. Yeah. To the point where, for those that don't know, every 90 minutes or so when we're recording this game, we take a break so he can go smoke and we can take drinks and stuff like that. And while that's happening, Andrew is watching anime on his iPad every single time because he's catching up on all the shit that he's behind on.
It's okay, and I've watched a lot of shit, and nothing's been this fucking bad about it. Like, I've never seen a show.
I can think of one show.
This much of an ass pull?
Yeah, it's the other story they made.
Oh, dangling grandpas.
that
doesn't count because it's based on a game.
Like,
the game is already.
We watched the anime, which was a really shitty adaptation of
the
game. Obviously,
worst way to fucking view that.
Yeah, but we didn't know that going in that it would be that bad of an adaptation. Because it's too short, first of all, which is the weird choice. But the second half of the anime. Was just 100% ass pulls.
Oh, yeah.
That's all it was.
It was just
the first
like,
half was like, oh, this is like, look at these investigations. The entire second half, just fucking hands flailing reveal, wacky wavy inflatable arm tubes plot.
Yeah.
It's like, what's happening?
Yeah, it's just, because again, that's an anime based on shitty writing. So, like, the game itself was already shit, and then it adapted that shit. So, like, it's not a fault of the anime.
It massively shorter.
Like, I'll even go to, like, the furthest degrees. Like, even Evangelion isn't this much of an asshole. And that's a fucking story that's just, like, the ultimate asshole, where it's like, well, one of these people has to be chosen to save the planet. I choose none. It wasn't part of the agreement. Well, yeah, but you guys were assholes about who's gonna get chosen, so I made up a new character.
Okay, let's move forward before Andrew starts spoiling every anime.
I'll get to that. Anyway, you thought he was Snake. Snake was one of the kids in your experiment
fucking
9 years ago.
Fucking Ace intensifies. Like, now they just added, like, gravity effects.
But his presence made you think. Snake was one of my subjects 9 years ago. He probably hates me.
Is that your best Ace voice?
Why isn't he saying anything? Is he keeping quiet because he can't see? Or perhaps he's working with Zero to get revenge on me? Whatever the reason, anyone who knows my past is a threat. Before he tries anything, I need to get rid of him.
Jesus.
That was when you decided you had to kill him.
Little did he know that literally only two people on this ship are not out to get him.
I'm trying to remember a detail. How was it again that Ace recognized Snake specifically? Because the one character on the entire ship he recognizes? Do you remember?
I think by looks. Or no, by,
But how? Because he can't.
No, I think it was, how did he recognize Snake?
And he wasn't blind yet 9 years ago, was he?
No.
So he wasn't blind yet. Like, at the time...
Maybe his voice was the same? Maybe his voice never changed through puberty?
Even though they leaned so hard on that excuse for why
they didn't. Well, that's why Santa's
anybody.
Voice changed, but I think maybe Snake was older than Santa? I think Snake is older than
Snake
Santa.
Snake is supposed to be older.
Yeah, so maybe Snake just has the same voice, and Ace was like, that voice sounds familiar. I don't know what those bags of clothes are saying, but it sounds like something Snake would say. Like,
just the idea that that's the only character he recognizes is...
It makes no sense because he doesn't recognize anything. He, like, literally is incapable of recognizing anything. Because Snake didn't wear those clothes at that
fucking
thing.
Yeah, his disability is so thorough he'll murder his friends on accident.
Yeah.
The murder weapon was Kubota's bracelet. You just waved it over the red. Verified your own number and then grabbed Nijisaki's arm and forced it over the scanner panel. Then, when the door opened, you kicked him in. 9 seconds later, the door closed.
And he was thankfully completely silent for those 9 seconds and made no attempt to get back out of the door or anything.
It wouldn't have mattered. It's too late.
But he doesn't know that. If he just woke up, he doesn't even know what the game is. So he could react, he could yell, he could do a billion things.
No, I meant
Ace.
Ace couldn't do anything. Even if he found out, it wouldn't have mattered because
it's
too late.
Yeah, I'm just saying that it's bizarre that Ace still doesn't know.
I think he pushed what he thought was 7 in and just walked away.
And he made no noise, no screaming, or hey, who are you? What's wrong with you, man? Or like just any reaction for 10 seconds?
I mean, maybe he realized what was going on. Like
his mouth's even open, like he's yelling right now in the frame. But he somehow made no noise that would make you recognize, oh yeah, it's my business partner and my assistant that I've been working with for apparently over a decade. And not that
more
one
than
guy.
That, for like 20 years.
Yeah, like somebody he's known for a huge chunk of his life, apparently. No ability to recognize him or even just recognize that it's not Snake.
I mean, look, Keith.
He'd definitely
when you,
make me, he wouldn't be like, oh,
when
this
you
is
have
my fate, I'll just do this silently.
When you have
maybe we'll pick up another document that says that his assistant was conveniently also a mute, so that everyone has a disability that makes this entire story possible.
When you have propeller's disease,
propeller's
you can't hear sounds either.
Prosopagnosia.
Popcorn? When you have
popcorn chicken.
Yeah, when you have popcorn chicken as a disease, you can't hear people after you've seen them.
What the fuck is that?
I don't know. Maybe once he put them in the door, like, he can no longer hear them. There's, like, a barrier that goes up, and it muffles sound.
Like, this is...
But we don't talk about the 9 incident, where,
it's
like, 9 clearly banged on the door.
This is that works if you're just gonna shoot someone.
Well, remember
as
we...
As opposed
we...
to slowly throwing them into a door that takes 9 seconds. Like, they weren't even in the room. He found this guy in a hallway, according to that scene, and had to take them
to the
room.
He found this guy in front of the door, based on the picture.
No, the picture was some hallway.
No, the picture was in front of the 3 door.
Was it?
Yeah.
It didn't look like the giant room at all.
There was a giant 3 on the door behind that guy when he was like walking in there.
Unfortunately, I can't go back to it.
Yeah.
But
when you're editing this, look at it, and you'll see a giant 3 behind that guy on the door, and you're like, how did you even get into this room? Because the door to this room is like all the way
on the
other
side.
Of the
room. Yeah.
So like, you walked in here and then walked specifically to that door, and then Ace
was like...
Maybe
they were in the corner by the wall or something, so it looked like a hallway at that angle. Because it totally looked like a hallway from when I was looking at it.
Because you didn't see any beds. That's why. They didn't show any of the beds in the picture, so you wouldn't know that he's in front
of
you.
Weird. But he still had time to grapple with somebody, pull them to a door, overpower them, throw them through the door, then wait 10 seconds. At no point
Keith,
he makes any noise.
The most important thing to recognize is that EZ-9 was literally about to die. All he said was...
Him.
He tricked
he
me.
Did it.
He did it. He could have easily been like, fucking Ace is goddamn pharmaceutical CEO. Get that motherfucker. And everybody would have been like, an end of Nonary Games.
I get that he was panicked, but at the same time, he was like spitefully trying to end the person who ended him.
Yeah.
And completely failing to just identify
him.
Even
if I was in a panic, I would shout a person's name.
Like,
I wouldn't say him by default.
He'd at least make the mistake of only saying his real name and everyone's like, who? That would at least make more sense than fucking
except
him.
For when you say like his name and then immediately 7 goes like Gondo Hogogo.
Yeah, oh,
wait. I know that person.
Talking about the amnesia coming
yeah,
back.
Yeah, it's like that's you. And then he just like I don't know. It's all fucking the whole game's just ass pulls. Let's just continue. It's fucking
And then 81 seconds passed.
That was silently.
And poor Nijisaki was dead.
At the dead.
And you mean to say Snake is still alive?
Sorry to disappoint you, but I'm as good as new.
No, you're not.
Thank
you're still
you
blind.
The wrong man.
Oh.
But I can't say I like knowing that you wanted me dead.
Or more brutally, he's also missing an entire arm.
He is still missing
an
arm.
Yeah. It's easy to forget because it's another one of those things that only comes up because it explains how he wasn't dead.
Although, to be honest, even if you hadn't tried to kill me, I would still hate you very much.
Wow.
Well, I wouldn't blame you.
Last but not least, let's talk about Musashido's death. When Clover and I were investigating the chart room, you came over to talk to me. Do you remember what you said?
Oh, a pocket watch. Might I take a look at it?
I handed it to you, and you left the room.
Is that why he takes it from us to solve it for us that one time? Is because like, oh yeah, I already know how to solve this because I just murdered somebody in the next room.
No, because he literally made this puzzle. So he knows the solution to all the puzzles.
Oh shit, he probably does. Yeah, he probably
does. So he just was like, that's why he didn't have to activate the screen. He just went like, move it to this hand, put it on the thing, walked in the room, found that guy in the room, and was like, axe.
Yeah, he borrows the pocket watch, goes over and murders the dude, then locks it again and comes back and gives you back the pocket watch later. But then also, when we had the pocket watch later, he just solves the puzzle for us anyway then too, because he'd already solved it again a moment ago.
Yeah.
That was surprisingly also story setup. But still incredibly frustrating, because the puzzle... If you're going to have the character solve a puzzle for me, I'd prefer the puzzle to be something I don't have all the information to solve yet.
Yeah, not something where the main character is just like, huh?
Yeah, in that situation, we literally were like, oh yeah, you do this. And we're like, how do I make him do it? You can't?
Yeah.
And then Ace does it, I'm like, what? Don't take credit from me. I solved it. Me, the human, that's real.
Human, that's right.
You had been in charge of the Nonary project. Of course you would have known the solution to every puzzle.
I mean, that is still a lot of puzzles to memorize.
You also knew how to get out of the wheelhouse. All you had to do was place the watch in the indentation on the door to unlock it. With the door open, you could enter the captain's quarters. Musashido was there.
Good thing he was quiet when he died.
Well, I don't think it would have mattered. I think the door that he was behind was a steel door. Practically begged you to kill him. But he was behind two different doors. He's behind two walls.
Let's wait for the explanation of how the fuck Ace recognized Musashido, by the way.
Yeah.
You picked up that axe and buried the blade deep in the other man's chest.
Why?
One blow was all it took. And then you returned to the chart room as if nothing had happened.
Yeah, wait, why did he do that?
Did Musashido identify himself vocally? Because he's wearing, like, generic-ass, like...
He's wearing... Well, he looks like he's wearing Snake's clothes again.
He's wearing costume clothes. Like, it's not his clothes.
Everybody on the ship is wearing Snake's clothes, but Snake?
Yeah, there's just, like... There must have been an exchange of some kind where he identified himself, which means that they were talking and then nobody heard.
It's two rooms away behind a steel door. I think it's enough... Like, I think the steel walls...
I don't know. Sound can go through stuff pretty easily sometimes.
Not that. I mean, but that's two rooms away. And we... Or three rooms away, technically, because we're in that one room, then there's one room where the puzzle is, then there's the Morse code room, and then there's the captain's quarters. So that's enough for the sound not to travel through. Because we didn't hear the explosion when Nijisaki's bracelet blew up.
We didn't know. But also, this room...
We didn't even feel vibrations, by the way. I'm sure they would have to vibrate, right?
Maybe, depending on how the explosion works. The thing I'm taking issue with a little bit is I think that when you're in the room, the wheelhouse room, I think that the entrance and exit, like, you know, the previous and next rooms, I think they're both in the same wall, which means that they share a wall.
Maybe.
So there are two rooms that share a wall on a ship.
I'd have to look at the map.
What's probably a rather excited vocal encounter between two characters, followed by maybe a blood-curdling murder scream as he gets axed to death. So... A bit of a surprise that he was able to do this completely silently without anyone questioning him.
Maybe Zero accounted for that and put soundproofing in front of the walls?
Or the fact that there's apparently a murder victim that apparently was still bleeding and it was a very fresh death in a room with two people that were with each other while one other person wandered off and no one questions whether the other person did it for even a moment.
Considering we found that, like, at the time, Ace took the pocket watch and then gave it back to us. Then we used the pocket watch to solve the solution to the door, and we didn't go like, wait, is that why you wanted the pocket watch, Ace? You wanted to do the door?
Like, at the time, we as the players didn't question it because we didn't think that... We didn't have any reason to think, as far as I can tell, that the body was new.
No, we didn't have any information that the body was new.
We don't get blood information. I think they specifically said that... Is it wet? Or like...
Yeah, I think they said the blood was dried.
Did it?
Yeah.
Which would it be? It wouldn't be that fast. He just got killed like a minute ago.
I mean, he wasn't killed a minute ago because we still kept talking with Clover.
For a little bit.
Yeah. Which, like, I mean, based on the fucking...
Judging by how the last flashback goes, a half an hour flashback is 30 seconds long in real time.
Yeah.
I don't know.
There was something I wanted to speak with you about, Junpei. Could you come with me for a moment?
I had no reason to say no, so I followed you to the wheelhouse. When we stepped inside, remember how you slipped your hand into my vest? You pulled out a piece of paper, the one I used to cheat during the vote. But that wasn't really what you were after. Your true purpose had been to slip the watch into my pocket. It wasn't a very good plan. Had way too many holes, and someone saying the wrong thing could have brought it all down around you.
Why was he slipping the watch into my pocket?
Yeah.
Didn't he take it?
Yeah.
Like, hey, can I have that watch? Thanks. Like, he didn't steal it. He didn't pickpocket it out of me, did he?
No.
I'm trying to remember.
He didn't. He asked for the watch, and you... Because remember...
Because he only frisked me once, right?
Yeah. The only reason you gave him the watch is because he barged in while you and Clover were having a private conversation, and you wanted him to leave, so you just gave him the watch.
Yeah.
If you said no, I bet he would have...
Why would he stealthily return it to me when I already know he had it?
I don't know. Maybe you're Junpei and you're a fucking idiot, so you forgot that he took it in the first place?
What in the world? You're either missing a detail or that's a really nonsensical plan.
Yeah.
You must have been desperate. But what made you willing to risk it all to do it? Ace, Musashito's murder is the only one I don't understand. You obviously did it, but why?
Because of this.
What's with the paper?
Just read it.
Oh, it's the note that explains left, right, and everything. And then that leads to the safe, which leads to, oh, he's the murderer.
Maybe?
No, that's what his body had.
Oh, right.
His body had the poem or whatever that leads you to getting to the safe.
Right, because if we don't go...
Which is the other place that explains that he's the bad guy, but also the same letter, the same picture shows up again.
Yeah, but how does Clover get it in that one ending?
What?
How does Clover get it in the one ending? One of the endings, Clover has it. But the body's still dead.
Yeah.
So Ace killed him but didn't notice the note?
Wait.
How the fuck did Clover get it anyway?
Wait, doesn't Ace... In the last set of doors, if you pick one door, you go with Seven and Lotus to die. But the other two options, in both cases, Ace goes with you, doesn't he?
Yeah.
So wherever you go, you're stuck with Ace?
Yes.
So in the one where we're with June, Santa, and Ace, Clover ends up with a note...
And bracelets.
So where was... Did they say the guy was dead in that version of the story? Who killed him?
If he wasn't, why would they not bring him with them?
Wait. Yeah, how did Captain die in the story where Ace didn't go that way? What the fuck?
Don't question it, Keith.
No, you have to question things. This is a mystery story.
No,
I'm trying to think back. I'm like, yeah, Ace came with us in that storyline to a different location.
It was their first time writing a mystery novel. They had some problems. Number two's better. Stop.
That feels too obvious. There has to be something I'm missing.
There's nothing.
Really?
Because who fucking else would have murdered him? Why would any of the other people murder a random fat dude that they found in a room?
I was going to think of, like, maybe Ace could have gone there, but then by then it's too late.
He would have had to go through the exit.
Because by then Clover already has the note, and by then he's already dead. That's confusing. Weird. Because, yeah, you only get the good ending, or the almost good ending that leads to this ending being possible, if you specifically don't let Ace go that way.
No, doesn't Santa go with Clover into that room?
So you think Santa kills him?
I think Santa kills him.
That's awful convenient how that guy dies no matter what in the same way with the same murder weapon.
That's the only excuse is that Santa would kill him, but then didn't take the note because there's no reason to take the note. He would want them to find the note. But he killed him because he's like, ah, fuck, Ace didn't go through this room. Plan's foiled. I'm going to go ahead and pop in, kill this guy real quick, and then pop back out.
Boy, that's a really, really risky plan.
It's also risky because both of these people didn't get blood on them.
I'm surprised.
Even though they attacked him from the front. And blood should have sprayed forward.
I'm surprised he doesn't have, like, a just kill that guy button. It's a lot more airtight plan than I need to specifically overpower him with an axe that's already in the room that he's waking up in that he might already have. Great plan, Santa.
He might have put the axe in the Morse code room.
Where was the axe?
The axe
was with him, wasn't it?
Well, the axe was with him because it was in his stomach. It was, like, lodged in his chest.
But didn't Ace find the axe in that room? Junpei just explained that the axe is in the room with Cap. So we're just, like, really lucky he didn't happen to seize that axe because he's panicking about where he is. Because he's realizing he's waking up in the Nonary game that he did before. So his first panic move
would be paid for.
Yeah. Like, he knows what it is, presumably. So his first panicked move about this kidnapping would be to grab the weapon in the room for self-defense. But somehow, in both versions of the story, somebody else gets it first and kills him with it, apparently?
Yep.
Even though... Yeah, what the... Okay... Boy, oh boy, I'm trying to decompress this story, but it's mostly turning into a web of nightmares.
Yeah.
Shit.
It's good, though, Keith.
Shit.
It's a good series. You just gotta understand anime like I do.
I don't think I'm missing something.
When you understand anime, Keith, everything is believable.
Stop evoking anime.
Moe moe for life.
Let's see.
Listen to this kawaii story.
Number one, there are two ways you might survive this ordeal. The first is to win the Nonary game. The second is for you to confess your sins of 9 years past.
Wait, this is a different
note
completely.
This is a different note completely?
I have prepared a camera in the captain's quarters. The images captured by that camera will be streamed through a satellite and distributed across the world. Simply look into the camera and repent.
We finally know why the goddamn camera exists.
Oh, so around the world
the
they just
made no sense. So I was like, well, I was waiting for a reason for it.
Well, that's awkward. So around the world they just watched us open a door.
did he not admit
well,
what happened?
I'm assuming not because he's dead. So I'm assuming. Wait, unless
so
you're
the idea is that this
unless
is
you're telling me the second, unless the route where like Ace doesn't go that route, he kills himself.
Is the idea here that if we find this note, everyone confesses whatever sins they have in front of this camera, and then everyone just lives, and that's the end?
That guy. Only that guy gets to live.
Oh, only Cap? Oh,
yeah, only Cap gets
like,
to
not
live.
Even nine?
Well, because Cap had no involvement besides
it
funding
sure
it. Remember, Captain didn't, like, kidnap the kids, he wasn't there on the boat, he only paid for the experiment to happen.
Did Captain already admit, then? Huh.
Once you have confessed everything, I will release you from this ship. To make your confession more credible, I have left you a witness in the captain's quarters.
No.
Wait, what?
No, the witness is Captain, so this note is for Ace. Ace is supposed to make a confession in that room with Captain.
So then, how?
But then he murdered Captain.
So who the fuck kills Captain when you don't go through that door?
Ha.
Perhaps he will confess with you. The decision is yours. Do as you please. Zero.
When I awoke in that room on D-Deck, I found that in my pocket. That was why I chose door one when we voted. If I went through that door, I knew I could get to the captain's quarters. As you said.
Oh no, he always chooses door one. Oh no, because if you choose a different door, the groups have to get shuffled.
Yeah.
Right, never mind. That,
yeah, that's what's confusing, is he was with us. It was Ace, Santa, June, and Junpei in the boiler room.
Yeah.
Which was the other branch.
Right, right, right.
Which is why we're so confused about, like, how does this work if he doesn't go that way?
Yeah, because that's how he gets the gun.
Huh.
My plan was to find the pocket watch before anyone else. If I could, then my alibi would be set. At least, that was the plan. Unfortunately for me, you got to it first. That sleight of hand was the best I could manage on short notice.
You meant to kill him from the beginning then? Musashido, I mean.
I only knew Musashido was the witness after I reached the captain's quarters.
I'm confused by how the part where they're like, it's 6 o'clock, we're out of time. And that was like a long time ago.
No, it wasn't.
And we're having, like, fun story time while everyone presumably still thinks they're gonna blow up.
This was 30 seconds ago, Keith.
Everyone thinks
this whole thing has been taking place in 30 seconds.
Everyone thinks they're gonna explode, right? That we never
changed
that?
I think the incinerator just turns on. No, the ship just starts to sink.
Oh, yeah, the ship sinks. Right, yeah. That's what the rumbling is.
So we just have to go up the stairs faster than the water kicks in. But I guess if the water kicks in the incinerator room, that's good? Because then we could just hide underwater.
So then we actually have a really soft... We actually have a strangely soft time limit because 6 o'clock is just when the ship starts sinking.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is way less final than the everyone blows up thing, which just feels more natural, but is not how it works in this case. Although, if you open the door too late, you just watch water.
Well, they close the incinerator door, so it's immune to water getting in?
Maybe.
It has to be airtight.
No, I mean like plush water, as in like if you try to get out of the ship when the door's already underwater, that's the exit.
Oh.
At some point, you're just like, oh, yeah. Fuck.
I asked him.
It becomes a submarine?
He seemed groggy. Perhaps he had only just awoken from sedation.
Sure, convenient.
I suppose Nijisaki was in much the same state. He seemed confused and disoriented when I encountered him. But yes, you are correct. I intended to kill him from the beginning, even though I didn't know who he was.
So Zero, what, did he like put an implant in both of these characters so he can inject them remotely with something that would wake them up at the exact moment that's convenient when they press a button? Because like that's...
No, I think he just put enough sedative in them that they would wake up in a given amount of time.
Yeah, but you don't even know in advance exactly how long parts of this Nonary game will take from moment to moment, and somehow both these people wake up right when Ace enters the room?
Conveniency.
It's insane.
I proceeded to the captain's quarters in order to remove this so-called witness.
Ace, you figured it out, haven't you? You were being manipulated.
Yes, so it would seem. I was little more than a puppet, in many ways. Everywhere I went, everything was already prepared. The Reds in the large hospital room were dismantled. Niji Saki was dressed like Snake.
You're right, that is the giant three.
Yeah, see?
That's what, like, the far...
But there's a door right next to the door, right next to the three.
Yeah.
Which makes no sense, because on the map, that's not where the door is.
Yeah, I thought that was a solid wall.
That was a solid wall.
This is the far left of the room, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, this camera angle always looked like a hallway to me. But yeah, it is the 783 room. Weird. And he's just right in front of the door that he needs to be in front of to die.
Yeah.
Like, he knew. Like, what the fuck?
There was an axe in the captain's quarters. Musashido was delirious from the anesthetic, so he couldn't fight back. Niji Saki as well. In retrospect, I can't understand how I could have fallen into such a simple trap.
You can't understand how you fell for the fact that you have face blindness?
You can't understand how the fact that you're just a terrible person?
I also can't understand a lot of things that are happening right now, to be clear, but... Sure.
But yes. Yes. This was a trap. It was Zero's trap. And I fell for it, hook, line, and sinker. I did everything he wanted me to do.
Haha, Ace, you activated my trap card.
Yeah? Same time, no one made you a murderer. You're that on your own.
No one said we gotta kill Nine. We've gotta kill Snake. We've gotta kill the captain. Like, no
being
one
a paranoid
said anything.
Murderer is pretty much on you. For all you know,
also,
these people...
Zero never said to kill anybody.
Also, for all you know, the people that are angry at you aren't murderers.
Yeah.
like
you're assuming these kids want to kill you, and you have no idea.
They might not be willing to kill anybody.
Yeah.
Ever.
After going through a Nonary game, maybe they're a little, like, more humble about murder. Like, the idea that they were put into a situation where they would kill, that they were gonna get killed, maybe they were like, you know, killing people is just not an okay thing to do. Let's just give them justice. Like, I'm also confused as how... I don't know. It doesn't matter. It doesn't fucking matter, but...
Yeah. By manipulating you, Zero was able to kill three people and keep the blood off his own hands. All of this was revenge for what happened 9 years ago. That's why this Nonary game happened. Am I right?
Do you think that any of us have bombs inside of us except for the people that are employees of Cradle's Pharmaceuticals? With how many contrivances that have happened, do you think that only the bad people have bombs?
Yeah, I think only the bad people have bombs.
And that all of us are just actually just safe unless Ace murders us all, which is what happens in several of the endings.
Yeah.
Because there's so many scenarios where we're all getting murdered one by one.
But yeah, I think none of us have bombs in us.
You think that maybe Zero just kidnaps us if we get thrown into a death room or something?
No, I think we just...
To
nothing
maintain
happens.
The belief that we died.
Yeah, I think nothing happens. But no one's willing to try it. You know?
Yeah. Well, Ace is.
What? No, he's not.
No, Ace is trying to... Ace is happy to get everyone killed.
Oh,
in that
yeah.
exact way.
I just meant that, like, yeah, I don't think any... no rational person's like, I don't know about all this fucking countdown bullshit. I'm just gonna stand here for 81 seconds and wait.
Lotus is pretty ready to call Zero's bluff at the beginning. It's like,
yeah.
No, I'm not playing his game. But then she just changes her mind.
Well, after someone blew up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Huh? What the hell are you talking about? I don't know any...
Ain't no point trying to play dumb anymore, Santa. Actually, I guess I should call you Aoi Kurashiki, huh? My memory came back to me, kid. You're Aoi Kurashiki. No doubt about it. Never thought I'd be back in this room talking to you. But hey... I guess this was all part of your plan, right? After all, The person who planned the Nonary game this time around was Zero. And Zero's you.
Looks like you really do have your memories back, huh? Well, I guess there's no point in hiding it then, huh? Yeah, you got me. I'm Aoi Kurishiki.
So did you inject Seven with amnesia juice?
Yes.
Is that a thing?
Maybe.
In this universe?
Probably. There's an incinerator with like 400 outputs for fire. Like,
why wasn't amnesia juice set up in a contrived conversation in a freezer at some point? Like, with just the number of...
Keith!
With the number of setup plot points that are foreshadowed, why didn't anyone ever talk about amnesia juice?
Keith! Because
that never came up. Morphogenic fields, dog photos, and amnesia juice.
Where's the mummy?
I'm actually consistently surprised it still hasn't come up.
Where's the mummy?
I'm waiting. Maybe Ice Nine's gonna come up next. Listen, we have a lot of question
marks.
What,
the fucking incinerator shoots Ice Nine?
This flowchart has a lot of question marks left.
Where's the mummy?
I was one of the kids in the Nonary game 9 years ago. I made it out. So did Snake over there. But there's one thing... I guess there's two things you got wrong. Number one, I ain't Zero.
What?
What?
It's June. June Zero. Because she's dead, but not dead. IS-9, mummy, something, revenge wraith, I don't know.
That's what a revenge wraith sounds like.
Sure, I was helping Zero out, but I'm really more of an assistant, like a secretary.
What?
Just a gun-toting secretary.
You're just like a shitty bitch boy? What the hell?
A secretary that has to hold hands with June for this entire game.
Are you saying for 9 years June's been stuck on a ship making shitty-ass puzzles?
No, the puzzles were already here.
Yeah, but she
That's the surprise, is that Zero didn't even make most of this shit.
But an assistant's only an assistant. I didn't come up with all this. All I did was follow Zero's orders.
Then... if you're not Zero, who is?
Calm down there, Junpei. Didn't I say two things? You made one more mistake. Junpei, you just said all of this was revenge for what happened 9 years ago. That's why this Nonary game happened. But that's not it. Revenge isn't the only purpose. There's another reason you guys were playing the Nonary game. To save someone.
Save someone?
Right. You were brought here to help my sister, to save Akane.
What the hell are you talking about? Akane Kurishiki died 9 years ago in this room. I was there, I saw... What? What the hell? Where is she? Where's Akane Kurishiki? My head! My head, it feels like it's gonna pop.
Is the reveal going to be that...
Holy shit.
Is June not real in this entire time?
No.
Santa had, like, both bracelets or
no,
something?
No, June is real, but it's time travel. What happened is, like, we... Oh, my God.
Are we inhabiting the bodies
of
the people?
This is fucking convoluted.
Are we inhabiting the bodies of the people from 9 years ago? Is that how we time traveled back?
No, I think that... I think it's, like, our Mighty Morphin
fields.
Power Rangers.
Morphogenic
sent,
fields.
Like, we did the thing. Alright, we just did the Nonary game. We all just did it because we're smart adults. Now we're sending that information
back
into the past.
So June cannot die. Maybe.
Seven! What the hell is going on?
I don't know. I just... Oh! I swear to God, my head feels like it's about to explode!
What was the Nonary Project? I'm sure you know already, but I'll tell you one more time. It was a project designed to test a particular phenomenon. And what was that phenomenon? For two organisms to communicate with one another in the absence of physical contact. The morphogenetic field theory. Could human beings use these invisible fields to exchange information? That was what this experiment was conducted to determine.
Did it work?
There were two separate locations. One was the gigantic, and the other was a building in Nevada called Building Q.
What if the next game takes place in Nevada at the same time as the 999?
I would fucking cut my wrist. I would cut it so hard. and just be done with this.
In building Q, we're faced with numerous puzzles, copies of identical ones in the gigantic. They were told to send their answers into the morphic field set and transmit them to their brothers and sisters on the gigantic. The transmitters were put in building Q, and the receivers were put on the gigantic. Each sibling pair was supposed to be split up, but there was a mistake. Akane was a transmitter. She should have been in building Q. However, for some reason, she was placed on the gigantic with the receivers, like me. Perhaps she was mistaken for someone who was supposed to be in Group A. Whatever the case, Akane ended up on the gigantic. I think I've told you enough. You get it, don't you? I'm pretty sure you know where this is going, Junpei.
Where what is going?
Don't play dumb. You know things you shouldn't. Things you couldn't. How did you know Ace had prosopagnosia? How did you know why Ace wanted to kill Kubota and how Nijisaki was killed? Were you surprised when you found out Ace was Hongo? And what about the coffin Snake was trapped in? How the hell did you open it?
Well, that's...
He knew because I knew.
Hi, this is God talking. I just wanted to let you guys know, thank you for playing 999. It's been a really good game.
Or but, it's June.
I guess. I don't know.
Because June set everything up. Maybe. Because she was a transmitter and Junpei's a receiver, right?
What a fucking crazy transmitter.
Junpei was receiving information that I sent through him to the morphic field set. It's simple, really. How do I know the alternate futures? Imagine a river that splits in two, like an upside-down Y. The river flows from top to bottom from a single stream into two branches. It only flows in one direction. It can never flow backward.
Oh.
Information's the same way. It moves from the past to the future, but never flows backward. That's why people at the river source in the past will never know about those downstream in the future. But the people downstream will never know about one another either. Information only flows along the path of the river. But I am different. I can manipulate the morphic field set to pluck knowledge from the future.
What?
I know what happens on either fork of the river. Even though the people on either fork know nothing about one another. Now, who am I? I am I, the ninth letter of the alphabet. Okay. But I'm also zero. No, that's not true. I'm not really a zero, not yet. Perhaps you could say that I am less than zero. Zero is my future. In 9 years, I will be zero. Where'd she go? June? No, Akane. Where'd you go?
Santa!
Was Clover... Oh, shit.
Freeze.
Santa's got the gun. Seems like not a problem, honestly.
Yeah, what's killing Ace gonna do?
Solve the problem of whether or not he does anything after this point? Guess he picked it up when we weren't watching. Looks like he turned the tables on Ace, though. Wonder how he likes having a gun to his head. How did Seven not take the gun?
How did nobody take this
gun? How did Seven jump Ace, the guy with the gun, and make no effort to get said gun? You know, the police officer that's disarming somebody didn't grab the gun. And then we just monologued for like 10 minutes?
I'm assuming he kicked it over to the other side of the room or something and just didn't give a shit when Junpei was monologuing.
That's insane.
Well, your immediate threat is to make sure that Ace doesn't get the gun ever. So he didn't think that Santa was going to grab the gun.
The way that he just continued to ignore the gun is insane for Seven
to do.
So it was
like everything.
Jesus Christ, Seven. Come on, man. MVP rescinded.
Get up.
Sure isn't about to take the gun off him for a minute, is he? Ace isn't putting up any kind of fight. I mean, I don't think I would either, but he looks kind of drained. I guess he is going for the door, huh? He doesn't need to verify to get to the door, but
Hey, what's your plan, Santa? What are you doing?
He can't get through any numbered doors with just two people. What the hell is he thinking?
Didn't I tell you? I'm Santa Claus. It's time for me to go make a wish come true.
That's it? That's all he's gonna give us? What the hell does that even mean? Shit, they're out.
Wait, what? How are they out?
Wait, did they just close the incinerator on us and we just let that happen? And now the gate's shut. Looks like the rest of us are stuck. Really?
What?
Guys, it's an incinerator, and you just heard a story about how it works.
What the fuck?
God damn it, everybody.
Is anybody in this fucking game capable of doing literally anything that a normal human would do?
It's a room full of so many people. It bothers me how everyone magically freezes for long periods of time when they should really be... At least some of them should try to save their own lives sometimes in these situations where all of them have free reign to do whatever the fuck they want for large stretches of time, basically. Because right now we have, what, like 6 people in the room or something? Like, it's a lot of people.
And, yeah.
And no one left?
No one.
No one was like, I'm gonna watch the door, see if it closes or not. Hey, there's a valve here. I can keep it open and shit. No? Lotus? Gonna be proactive? We'll be right back.